Hey guys, happy Saturday. Thank you for coming in tonight. I appreciate it. And thanks replay viewers for watching here on Facebook Live. And thank you also for watching on YouTube. This will go live, or this will go up on YouTube at Penguin and Fish Movies on YouTube. And it'll stay here on the Penguin and Fish page as well. So, all right, guys, let's continue. Last night we got all of our yellow guys sewn on. We showed you a whip stitch, which you can see here, versus a ladder stitch, which is pretty invisible right here. So those are the two different stitches we showed you yesterday, so be sure to check out that video. I ended up going with whip stitch for the rest, just because it was more, I guess, comfortable for my hands. But there is something nice about that ladder stitch that you can't see it. All right, I'm going to flip you around and we'll get going here tonight. Oops, sorry guys. There we go. Hey everyone. So here it is. This is where we got to last night. Look how cute it is. It's a cute little sunshine with the little bunny. Oh, there's the hubs giving me a bunch of hearts on Facebook. So, all right, guys, here we are. We're going to continue this tonight. It's block 82 of the Splendid Sampler. I am loving it. It's been so much fun to kind of do this handwork again. This is English paper piecing, which means we've taken a bunch of little pieces of paper. I'm using scrap paper, so it's kind of silly, but little cardstock, and we made all the shapes. And we're basically wrapping the fabric around the shapes and then stitching them to each other. So that's what we're doing tonight. We're going to continue on with that. We're going to continue with all these blue bits that will fill in all these holes tonight. So we'll see how far we get. Again, this will be the last night of this because it's New Black Sunday tomorrow. We're working through the Splendid Sampler quilt along, and all the blocks are free right now. There's new ones every Thursday and Sunday, so you can check out thesplendidsampler.com. Otherwise, we do other craftiness here at on our little Penguin and Fish live streams. If you're new here, my name is Alyssa Thomas from Penguin and Fish, where we make lovely and quirky hand embroidery patterns and kits. I'm the author of Sew and Stitch Embroidery and a fabric designer, and I'm here every night at 9:30 p.m. Central, where we make crafty things, and we've been working through the Splendid Sampler quilt along. And we're gonna keep doing that until we catch up. I'm still 16 or so behind, and after tonight I'll be 17 behind yet, so if you're just starting, don't worry, we will get them done at some point here. So alright, I'm gonna flip you around and we'll get started. Alright, and let me know what you guys are up to tonight. Hello, Anna, thanks for coming in from Argentina. Must be early there, or like afternoon there, maybe? Probably early morning there, right? So yesterday, we started right here on the blues. We did all the yellows, these rays, so we went all the way around the edge to sew on these little shapes. And then we ended up here, and we just started the blue right away with the same thread. So I don't have it on here yet. This will be where we end up. But we managed to get all the way to the top of this one, so now I'm going to just start from the top there and keep going. So the next piece is one of these. Let's see, this is a C piece. Yeah, a C piece. Oops, I think I just loosened my glue there. Yeah, you know what, I just loosened the glue there, so I'm going to grab my glue and we'll just put another little dab on it. So this is just kind of like an inexpensive little water-based kind of glue, just a plain old glue stick. And we haven't done any like really intense use of the glue stick with English paper piecing. Oh, it's past midnight there. Funny. So this is kind of my first time really digging into the glue version of this. Usually I thread-based it. So there's one little thing, my glue is not necessarily sticking for very long, which is actually okay because it'll be easier to pop these guys out. Yeah, so I'm gluing all of these. We have done English paper piecing in the past on the Splendid Sampler. I have older videos where we do the whole process of thread basting. That's another way of doing it. We're attempting a fully glue basted one, which I have not done before. So, all right, this is the next guy up there. Let's get some thread. You're so into glue. I am just starting to discover the beauty of using glue with quilting. It really does speed up the process. You know, I always was like, oh, do I really want to be putting glue all over my fabric? But it really hasn't been that big of a deal. And it really has saved a bit of time. So that's been kind of nice. It's been very nice. So, all right, starting up in this corner here. So we need to put, we're gonna start up here. So I need to put like these two edges together right now. So you kind of put like right sides together like that. So I'm gonna just put that flap out of the way. I'm gonna line up the beginning and end of these. All right, there we are. So my point is up here. I'm gonna just get that ear flap out of the way. I'm gonna go in both of those sides. Now I didn't tie a knot this time. I think we're gonna go around twice maybe and then try and tie a knot. I don't know, I'm trying something new tonight. So I kind of like going, like one or two times around a corner just to kind of lock it in place. There, I'm wondering if I don't even need a knot anymore. So instead of tying a knot, all I did is go around that point about three times, and now this seems kind of locked in place. I think maybe I'll just skip the knot. I've never done that before. We'll see how it goes. So I'm gonna whip stitch this again. So whip stitching is just when my stitch is on the top now and I'm moving over just like a stitch length away and going from the bottom to the top, just straight up. And we will do our first little whip stitch, get the thread around that little ear. All right, so that's our first whip stitch and I'm gonna continue just doing that. So bottom, a stitch length away, going from bottom to top, just perpendicular to those two shapes. And I'm not going through the paper at all. I am just going through a couple little threads of the fabric on either side. Oops, got a little one of those loopy knots. If you get one of these knots in here like this, where it's just a loop like this. Ooh, I got like two little loops. But yeah, so if you get a little loop knot like this, which is really common, a way to deal with that is just put your needle right in the loop and pull up on it. The knot will go right up to the needle and then you should just be able to, where'd it go? You should just be able to pop that knot right out after that. There, so there, it's gone now. I'm sure we'll get more of those. It just comes from the thread wrapping around itself. All right, but I'm gonna continue the down to up whip stitches in here. It looks difficult because there's kind of a lot going on. I mean, we're working on a little bit more of the difficult part of this English paper piecing because we're working on Y seams. We have these triangles and we need to, you know, get that Y-shaped angle in there. And that's, I think, maybe what would make this just a hair more difficult. Use some of our other little shapes. But you're really just putting two edges together and stitching through it. So we've prepped all our pieces all at once. So if you're just watching for the first time, it might be confusing. Well, how did we get our pieces of paper like this? And how did we get our fabric around these shapes? We go over that. We went over that 2 days ago. So that was Thanksgiving, wasn't it? So on Thanksgiving, we did a video on that. And then yesterday we did our first group, sewed all these yellow sun rays on, and then today we're just continuing that. I'm just going all the way down this edge till I reach the point. And when this whole entire block is sewn together, then we'll pop out all of our pieces. Your glue stick says washable glue, but it's more like, oh, paste which dries quickly. That should be okay. I mean, have you tried it out? Quick. The quickness of it is nice. That's kind of why I like this glue stick. I know a lot of people, when they do all their stuff, they like kind of an Elmer's glue. How do you secure the outer edges where all the points meet? So are you saying like here? I'm just securing it the same way I'm securing all the edges or all the points. Once I get to a point, I'm just going around it a couple more times. So I'll show you in a sec here. It's funny, my pinky finger is doing that thing again, which apparently is my deal with paper piecing. It's kind of like hanging out here, like I'm sipping tea or something, you know? Got my little finger. I feel like it's balancing out the rest of my hand. I don't know what it's doing out there. But all right, so I'm getting to a point here. So see if I can get closer here. So we have a point on our blue and the point on the yellow. And this actually runs into the point of our main octagon too. This is like a 3-point thing, but we're gonna just worry about it going through this yellow. I'm gonna go through both like it's a normal stitch. And then I'm going to go just through it again, and that'll kind of lock it in place. So I got one little extra stick in there, stitch in there. So, all right, so that's the first side of that one. And we actually have, this isn't the final point. We do actually have, like, this guy will go in there too. All right, so let's go up this side. So now this is where the Y seams can get tricky. Let's move our flaps out of the way. So I need to line up these edges, but that's also gonna force me to kind of bend my papers a little bit to kind of maneuver this edge. So see, I'm kind of bending the Y angle in there. Just because it won't lay flat by itself, because, you know, we got some weird octagon-y sort of bowl-looking thing going here. Oh, look, this is popping out already, but that's okay. We're done with that piece. All right, so I'm going to grab the bottom corner of this yellow, the next yellow piece here, and I'm going to do the same thing that I just did on the other side. I'm just going to put two little stitches, and I might even try and get some of this octagon fabric just to kind of secure that corner again. Just really, really, really lock down that corner. So we'll take a look at that when we're done with this side. So now I'm gonna just continue my whip stitch. I got these two edges together. I am still kind of bending this Y seam, so it works for me. Got that ear in the way. After a few stitches, I should be okay, away from this ear, and I can straighten out a little bit more. A few more in there. Oop, got stuck again. So I gotta tell ya, I am liking this whole 4-day weekend thing. We had Thanksgiving on Thursday, then we kind of did nothing on Friday either, and today I was hoping to get some work done, but instead we went for a really long walk. Not really long, but longer than we usually do, a few miles I think. Walked to the pizza place that we like, ate some pizza, walked home, and that was basically our day. So tomorrow, hopefully, I'll get some stuff done before the real work day starts again. But man, we needed a little break in there, so it was definitely nice having this holiday pop up. The hexes were easier. Yeah, the hexes, the Y seams are not as extreme, so it's a little easier to do the Y seams. But and you know, you're just dealing with hexes, so it all the hexagons, so it you know, you get used to the shape, and you know they always fit next to each other and stuff. This is definitely more a little bit of a puzzle piece, and sometimes some of these triangle points, when it's like an acute angle versus an obtuse angle, like a wider angle on the hexagons, it's like more of a triangle point, or a tighter triangle. Those can be a little different because you got the little ears to deal with them too. But all right, we're getting to the top of this guy, and once we get to the top, I'll do that little double stitch just to kind of lock in that point. I don't really know if that's really necessary, but I'm just in the habit of it now. I kind of like doing it. Get a few threads there. I think the next stitch will be my last. Oops, got stuck all the way down here. Went all the way around a ray down there. All right, here we are. Last stitch up here. This is the top of that point. And I'll do one more stitch to kind of lock it in place. And we'll see what we got here. All right, so now, you know, I can unbend this little paper thing to lay it flat again, but there, that fits in well. So we're shaping the top of this thing. Again, on these ones are where this guy and, you know, now one of these will end up being, so ooh, that'll be cute. And we'll end up stitching these last, it looks like. So let's keep going. Next piece is one of these skinnier triangles. And these are the triangles that we've left. We've left this top open. That's where our seam allowance is going to be. So we only really need to go up up to here. All right, so this guy will fit right in there. Oh, and here's that corner. So we put our little double stitch in there in these corners to kind of hold them in place there. And I think that looks pretty good. I really like this blue. We actually changed this blue early in the game here. I thought I was going to go with a darker blue, but then it just didn't seem sunshiny enough. So this is the edge that we're going to do, so I'm going to just fold it over here. Let's try and... Whew, man, I can't pick up this little tiny needle. It's funny. Oh, I'm stuck on this corner. Alrighty. These are matched together, so I just flopped this guy out of the way again. Let's match up these bottom points. There, that looks pretty good there. And now up on the top here. All right. I'm going to go through my yellow piece again and grab the other side. And I'm going to stitch the two in place again. Lock that in there. Look at my pinky trying to balance it out over here. Oh man, I don't know what's going on. Feels like it's going to cramp up if I have it down like that though, so I suppose it's up like this. Yeah, I like this blue better here too. And the only reason I'm kind of keeping this dark blue outside is because it has the clouds in it, and I think the clouds fit with our little sunshiny deal. It'll be like the sun breaking through the clouds. I like that idea. Hey, Debbie, thanks for coming in. Oops, dropped my needle again. Sheesh, a weesh. I'm used to a needle that's a little longer, so, oh man, now I have knots too. So this is just feeling a little funny in my hands. Oh, we watched another movie today too. So we're getting a lot of movies in this little vacation weekend here over Thanksgiving. We watched Joy, which is that one with Jennifer Lawrence, where it's Joy something. I don't remember her last name, but where she invented that mop, like based on the true story. So inventing this mop and as like a mom and going on QVC and that sort of thing. It was pretty interesting. Basically had the same cast as the Silver Linings Playbook. So it was her and Bradley Cooper and Robert De Niro. Those three, basically. It was okay. Cute. Fun to just chill on the couch again, that's for sure. Then we went for a long walk. It was so beautiful. I think I saw it on HBO. We have that HBO To Go app through iTunes. And so I think it was actually on there. They have movies that come and go over there. And then we watched, what was it, War Dogs the other night? I think it's called War Dogs. That was that one, that true story of, like, those 20-somethings who became, like, small contractor arms dealers for the U.S. government. That was pretty fascinating. That one we actually rented on iTunes. Ooh, but on Netflix yesterday, I did watch all the Gilmore Girls. All the new, like, 4-part miniseries thing that they did. That was good. It felt just like the show, which is what I was worried it wasn't going to feel like. So I liked it. Did you get some of the paper? Oh, I did. Yeah, I did get some of the paper piece dressed done. So that's a foundation paper piecing, a little bit different than what we're doing here. All right, we're switching the edge. But yep, I got the whole dress done. I don't have the block done. I gotta do all the other parts of that, but let's get a little fold in here, trying to get this to match up. Let's get it started here. I think it'll help me with this corner. But I did get the dress done. Now we just have that little thread spool and that little tiny needle paper piece that's on that one. So again, getting further with the blocks. I'm not far enough with any of the blocks, of my unfinished blocks. I'm not far enough with any of them where I'd be able to finish it in a sitting. I'm that behind on all of them. All right, I gotta get these two together. I kind of had trouble locking these two together last time, too. I think I just need to really get that bend in there, and that will help relieve some of this. So there, I think we're good now. There we go. Get my finger in there, folding up around that. Now I can see both edges together. Just a little bit. I'll have to tweak it a little bit right here. Grab the bottom. Top piece. Now we're going. You had a hard time with yours? For the dress block, I had a hard time. I didn't have a hard time, but I've improved since I started. So I think if I would do the top again, the top of the, like, the bodice part, I think I'd probably do a little bit better job than I did when I started. We've done a lot of paper piecing since then, and there's some tricks. Oh, yes, it's Pat's birthday. So Pat Sloan is one of the people who started this quilt along. And it's her birthday today. So happy birthday to Pat. You're 9 blocks behind. That is not bad at all, Anna. I am, like I said, I won't finish this tonight, and we have a new block tomorrow, so this is my new unfinished 17, number 17. We were able to get a few done in the past couple of weeks extra, so I went from 17 to 16 for a little while, but now with this one, I'm back up to 17. And like I said, all of those blocks are going to require more than a session to finish. I think this might be the only block that I might, I mean, we'll see how far we get tonight, but this might be the only one that we might get one more, might be a one session block. Like if we have a free day, we might be able to finish it in one. You made 3 today. Holy cow. That was a good day. That's pretty awesome. Yeah, I've been thinking I might have to do another little mini marathon one of these weekends or something, you know, or like do like a four hour live stream or something. Get ahead on some of them or finish up, like, you know, maybe it's a four hours of paper piecing or something, you know, and we just work on all of the paper piecing blocks that I have unfinished and see how far we get in 4 hours or something. I don't know. Oh, there is a new block. Oh, and for you, it's a new block day. That's right. You're 7 behind and missing this when the end comes. Yeah, I know, right? Let's hope that tomorrow's block is just a done-in-one-day block. I think I've only finished 2 blocks in one day, or 2 or 3 blocks. There hasn't been many of those. But yeah. If we can scream through one of those, then we'll have a couple days to get some blocks done. All right, here's my last stitch up the top here. All afternoon and part of the night you're sewing, oh man. But yeah, you know what? I think maybe we gotta, I'm gonna put one more in here. Do a, like a four hour marathon. All right. There's that one, a whole another piece in there, woohoo! All right, so, oh, we did this one today too, so we got 2 in so far, that's great. All right, let's go to the next one. So it's another one of these wider triangles, so let's get that in. Oh, I wonder how many more. I think we maybe will be able to do 2 more tonight. But then we still have 2 left. Oh, and then a 2 and a little bit of this one. Ooh, I don't know if we'll get it in one more session. This might still be a 2 session finisher. Hope it had something else for when this mystery finishes. I know, right? Well, I'm hoping to do, I have the whole alphabet of little embroidery patterns, and I was thinking maybe I'd do a little embroidery along, I suppose. Stitch along, there, let's call it that. I designed a quilt that you can have the whole alphabet of these, they're like cute little characters. I draw like cutesy little animals and stuff. And I did a little animal for each letter of the alphabet. And they go together in this quilt, and I thought that would be kind of a fun big project. But I wouldn't do 2 a week like this. I don't think that'd be a lot of embroidery. But maybe 1 a week. 1 little embroidery a week. Then we'd still probably have time for some other things. Because the embroidery would take, I don't know, maybe 3 sessions or so each. And then we still have a couple other days. Do so after by yourself. For like this embroidery thing or for this quilt? For the embroidery thing, I mean, I don't have it all worked out yet. It'd be kind of, you know, I'm kind of curious what you guys think. Maybe I'll send a newsletter asking stuff about it, just like what you guys would be interested in, like if you'd be interested in doing the whole alphabet or, you know, the alphabet and then how to sew it in a quilt right afterwards and then get the quilt design too, or, I don't know, that might be kind of fun. Then the nice thing is, you know, it'd be nice to have something done. They fit for my quilt. I think the blocks end up being around 7 inches, I believe, for the quilt. But the actual embroideries are like between, like with a rectangle that's like 3 to 5 inches big. You know, some of the characters are different size shapes, but I don't think they really exceed 5 inches. And it's just cute little outlines too. You don't have to fill it in. I mean, you can really embroider it however you want, but it's just cute little outlines. Some cute French knots, cute chain stitches, a bunch of cute stitches. So I'm thinking we'll do something like that. And then I could also, I'll do like little videos on how to do a French knot and some of the things that might be making your French knots not work for you, like some of the pitfalls of French knots and how to correct them and how to do, you know, the back stitch, how to do the chain stitch, all those. I'd do pepper in like little video how-to videos, I think, especially if one of the blocks, one of the animals has those stitches in, we would do those. So I don't know. I haven't thought too much about it, but it'd be a fun kind of longish project just to kind of chill, do some embroidery, and end up with a really cute quilt when you're done. Oh, totally. Yeah, it would be a perfect for, like, it'd be a nice size lap quilt. That would definitely be great for a kid and something that, you know, could last a long time and stuff, because, you know, you're spending a lot of time on the embroidery. You know, this is helping by folding it first and then lining it up. I think that actually made that really easy. So let's keep going. I'm gonna grab on this yellow corner now and grab the blue corner and go around that twice. But yeah, so that's something I'm noodling around with. If you're on my newsletter and stuff, you probably haven't heard from me in a little while, and I'm hoping to rectify that really soon here too. I think I might, you know, talk about this Facebook Live, because not everyone knows that we moved here yet to Facebook Live versus Periscope. And, you know, there's still that question, like, how to get the live notifications and stuff. So I think I'm going to send a newsletter out about that soon again. But yeah, so I will definitely talk about, ask you guys' questions on what you think for this embroidery sew-along thing and stuff too, and get your feedback, because I want it to be something that you guys want to do. I don't want it to be like a project that you're not interested in. So I think that's the deal. We'll see. But I'm definitely not going to I'm not going to start that while this Splendid Sampler is still going on, that's for sure, because this is totally taking up all of my evening time here, and which is perfectly fine. I'm having fun taking on this big kind of quilting project. This is the biggest quilting project I've done for sure. I don't usually take on projects this big. They freak me out sometimes. I like having like little wins, you know what I mean? Like, that's why I kind of like embroidery. It's a quick win, you know? You watch a couple movies and you're done, right? But I suppose that's it's feeling like this, the Splendid Sampler, because we're doing just these little blocks, so each block is like its own little win. It's easier it's easier to chew, you know, than if they were like, here's all the blocks and here's the whole thing, what's gonna look like done. I mean, I would probably would have panicked a little bit if I saw everything before doing it. All right, night, Jennifer. Thanks for coming in. All right, we are almost to the top of this one. This one's going really quickly, this triangle. Hey, we only have one of those triangles left. Wow, how'd that happen? That's awesome. All right, Judith, have a good evening. All right, almost to the top, a few more stitches here. Yes, the Splendid Sampler is definitely taking a bunch of time, but it's kind of nice. It's nice to work on a big project. But it'll be nice to, because in the evenings here, we used to do a bunch of different crafty things, like everything from embroidery to like even darning and knitting and crochet and all that, and quilting. It'd be fun to do some of that again too, not just quilting. So, all right, that guy is in. Oh my gosh, we're like halfway done. It totally looks like we're halfway. Oh, except it goes like this. There we go. It looks like this is the square, but it's not. The square gets bigger when we get these guys on. I was kind of like peeking. So let's peek at what these look like. Ba-doop. And now we got one down here too. It's cute. All right. Another one of these guys, these skinny ones. Oh, agreed on the big project. Oh, okay. Sorry, Judith. Oh, you would? Okay, so that's awesome. So I'm just trying to figure out how that would all work. And I actually have some big news coming up that I can probably talk about soon. And it's one of the reasons I've been a little MIA lately, except for you guys, who I get to see every night here. But I will be able to talk about that soon, and I'm pretty excited. I'll be able to get my embroidery kits and some patterns to a lot bigger, a lot more people soon. And, you know, so my mission to get everyone crafting and, you know, everyone to like feel just like how awesome it is to craft, how meditative, how relaxing, how fulfilling it is to work on a project. I'm getting a little closer to that goal this coming year, so I'll talk about that soon. But been a little tied up with that, but I'm hoping to get back on the newsletters again and everything else. So I apologize if you're missing me in places. I'm just happy, like, I don't know what I would do without this evening with you guys. I'd be super sad. Doing the Farm Girl Vintage and Splendid Sampler. Holy cow, you're doing a ton of things. Too much to do at once. Yeah, yeah, that's definitely why I probably won't start this embroidery thing till a hair later. Because, like I said, I'm also going to be 17 blocks behind. So even when the Splendid Sampler is done, I will need to be working on the Splendid Sampler for a while to get it done. You know, maybe that's why I should maybe definitely schedule some of these four hour sessions. Like I could do a couple 4 hour weekend sessions or something. I don't know, maybe every Saturday I should do like a 4 hour session during the day. I don't know, when would be a good day for you guys if you wanted just a 4 hour live video that you can hop in and out? I wonder if we can catch up on some blocks, because it would be nice to be able to finish the Splendid Sampler on time so we can start doing the quilt of it all. You know, because we want to sew this into a quilt, and I'd love to do that here and everything too. But man, that means it'd be nice to be caught up. So yeah, some of these sessions, I'm totally, you guys, if I'm rambling, just let me know. I'm totally just saying everything that my brain is thinking, trying to like plan, how am I going to get this done on time? And yeah, I think I need a couple 4 hour sessions. Any day for you? Okay. So I'm thinking it probably makes most sense on a weekend since people work. Not everyone works. But I think maybe either, so some Saturdays or Sunday, but maybe I should make it like a regular thing for a little while. Oh, you're doing the Splendid Sampler in two colorways. Weekends are good for you. Sundays are good. Okay, Sundays. And, you know, it would be, I would save it. It would be on my Facebook page too. But, you know, if you just wanted to come pop in and chat for a little while and pop out and, you know, do more laundry and then pop back in or something, that's how it would be for me. I'd watch someone and then do a load of laundry and get that started and then watch it for more folding or something. All right, anytime, Australia. Oh, you'll have to see in the replay anyway. Yeah, I'm just thinking, I'm kind of itching to get a little caught up. Saturday, I think Saturday's probably the best for me. Saturday for me still feels like a free day of the weekend. Sundays for me, I start to start planning for my week and I get more kind of workish. Oh yeah, that's right. We do have a week or two over the Christmas holidays. So I'm doing that again. I'm just kind of bending in the middle to start out. And oh man, that's so much easier. Okay, totally do that. Bend it and then match up your edge. That's working so much easier than it was. Great. So why don't we do, I know that's good that we have those days to catch up, but maybe I'll add into this another day session on Saturdays or something. I'm gonna have to see. I'll have to look at my calendar a little bit. We have a few things coming up here, but I think that would be nice. Just a little session during the day, get a little farther on something. I think that would feel good. And then I would still do my evening things as well. But yeah, I think we have Christmas off and we have New Year's off. Those are, I think, the only times when we aren't getting new blocks. So that's good. We'll get a little leeway in there. I don't think that's going to be enough leeway for me to get caught up, though, still. So a few Saturday sessions plus that little extra time over the holidays. Maybe we'd get close to caught up then. You know, I think one of the things that's making this block go fast is that we prepped all the pieces beforehand, because I'm feeling that too. I'm feeling like this is going so much faster than normal paper, or like than paper piecing is in my brain normally. Yeah, so we could put a wonder clip here. We did that yesterday, but I think now this folding thing is working okay for me. I'm just gonna just to not have one other gadget here. I think this is doing the job just right for my hands right now. I'm kind of going by feel. Like if my hands get too tired, you know, then I'll switch to something else. And I don't know if I'd be able to do a 4-hour session of English paper piecing though like this. I mean, this hour is plenty for my hands. But, you know, I have a lot of foundation paper piecing blocks to do yet. It'd be fun to just have a whole foundation paper piecing. That's the one where we sew on the paper. I could easily fill up a couple 4-hour sessions with all my unfinished blocks of those. So that might be kind of fun. And then also there's a pile of embroidery and all that. Your thumb is sore from this. Yeah, I mean, this is not, I can tell you that this will never be, well, you know, never say never, but I don't think this will really be one of my go-to crafts ever that I just, like, super love, because this is kind of a hard position for my hands to be in. Like, this squeezing position, I don't always do totally well with that. And I know it's kind of similar to embroidery, but I don't know, for some reason I feel like I have to really hold on with this. I don't know. Maybe I just don't have a feel for it quite yet. All right, well, that guy's on. You know what? I think we can start another one yet. This we're kind of cruising at this point. So let's, and this one, these guys were pretty easy. Ooh, maybe we're approaching that we'll be able to do this in one session. so nice to just be able to flop that guy down out of the way. All right, let's match up these corners down here first. That's going to be the important point, is down here in the corner. Yeah, hexies are I think, less stressful on the hands, too. They're pretty cute. Pretty cute. Yeah, so I think, you know, a lot of my other blocks that are unfinished. So I have a lot of, you know, I have a foundation paper piecing. So that we could definitely do a few sessions on. But then my other things are all kind of handwork. And I'm thinking 4 hours is kind of a lot for handwork. So maybe we do a couple foundation paper piecing and then we switch to, you know, the last hour or something is embroidery or something. And then we do more foundation paper piecing and then the last hour, the next week is, you know, some of this English paper piecing, or we have some needle turn applique. I don't know. We have a whole pile of stuff. Oh, and we do actually have a few normal pieced blocks that need to be finished too. Like one I haven't even started. That one we need to get going for sure. We'll see how it goes. I mean, we might not even finish a block in 4 hours, you know what I mean? Like, some of these are pretty intricate. All the more reason to set away some Saturday 4 hour, you know, 2 to 4 hour. I think 4 hours is good. I think that's as long as Facebook Live kind of goes. Some longer sessions. All right. I think it's a good plan. I keep talking about it. I think I'm trying to convince myself that that's a good idea. Oh, so, Susan, I can see your comments. If I'm not responding to comments as much today, it's because I'm having a harder time versus when I'm just machine sewing, looking at the screen and at my needle at the same time. Oh, but I was gonna say I started my that sourdough starter that we were talking about the other day. This is day two. So I found some instructions on the internet to make a sourdough starter. I haven't read up on how to actually make the bread yet, but I have a couple more days to do the starter. So it's basically 4 ounces, and I measure it on a scale, so 4 ounces of flour and 4 ounces of water mixed together, and you do that every day for like 5 days, basically, and then your starter is, you know, as long as it's bubbly and all that, from the air, there's no added extra yeast, commercial yeast. So in theory, by day 5, it should be bubbly and good to go. And then I'll look up how to do a sourdough bread. I just got curious about it lately, but I'm excited. I'm like feeding this thing, feeding the yeast bomb. You haven't been seeing everyone else's comments. Oh. There is a new thing on Facebook, Susan, that if you swipe, I don't remember if it's left or right, but it'll make the comments disappear. Because sometimes people just want to watch a video. They don't want to see all the comments on the video. So try swiping in one direction or the other, and comments will either appear or go away. But that could be a reason why. All right, we're approaching the bottom of this one. One more stitch in here. And we are almost running out of thread again. Yeah, I'm so excited for it. I don't make bread ever. So it's kind of, and I like this idea of the natural yeast versus commercial yeast. So I'm pretty stoked. You see old ones though in yours. Not quite sure. All right, so let's try and do the other side of this. I gotta definitely, my corners kind of matched up funny down here, so I definitely wanna fix that a little bit. I wanna make sure I grab some of this octagon in here because we're a little off. So you're just not seeing anybody's? Let's get yellow ears here. There we go. Just want to get in the corner of that octagon. Oh, thanks, Debbie. I'm having fun with this one for sure. I think I was saying this earlier. I think I like paper piecing fun shapes together like this versus just like hexagons. There we go. So I just tightened that little corner, sucked it in a little bit. I think I'm gonna need one more stitch to lock that in place though with this octagon. It's hard for me to see, so I'm not doing the stitch in one movement. I'm kind of going just through the octagon, and then I'll bend through the blue. All right, there we go. Lock in that corner. I know! Isn't that crazy? I didn't think I'd get this far today. So, all right, let's do that little fold again. That's been working pretty well tonight. And then match up that edge there. And we're ready to keep going. So I'm gonna grab that yellow corner and again go around that blue corner. So I've been this corner on the blue, I've done this double stitch around three edges now, or three points now. This yellow one, the octagon, and then this yellow one. I'm about to lose my thread in on the needle here. I'm not sure we'll make it all the way. Oh yeah, we should make it all the way to the top on this one. How are we doing in time? I think I'll go to the top on this and then we'll probably call it a night here. But yeah, I think I got a little farther on this than I thought I would tonight. So fast. I think this whip stitch is faster for me too than the ladder stitch. That's kind of why I went with the whip stitch, even though the stitches are more visible. I might not make it all the way up here actually. That's okay. But yeah, so now that I'm you know, I got a little farther. Like, I think we got, like, two farther. Yeah, like, maybe two farther than I thought I was going to tonight, or at least one further. And so maybe this will be one more session block. It'll be my only one more session block, which is kind of funny that a one more session block would be a paper piece block. Because usually these take a whole lot longer, at least they do in my head. So I think, you know, I think it's probably this design. The design's deceiving. So the design makes it look like it's really intricate and has a lot going on, but it's actually going pretty quickly. Yeah, we have one more piece and then an edge, because I only have one edge of, like, there's only one edge of this guy done. So a whole piece here and then that little bit. Can't wait to do this block. Oh, that's awesome, Susan. Yeah, I'm kind of, you know, I don't see this just because of my hands being something I do all the time, but it is fun. I do like the hand work. It's just a lot for me. But I think if I did a... oh, that's good. That's great. I hope this is helpful. But I think I think with the Wonder Clips, I think that might alleviate my hands a little bit. So if I had to do this more than the hour here, I think I'd try to use the Wonder Clips. I'm gonna attempt to get all the way to the top here because it's just, you know, like four more stitches or something. I'll have enough to tie a knot then. Yeah, and again, this is the first time I'm really doing this glue method, and I'm totally liking it for just speed and ease. And it is, you do get a sharper edge, so it is easier, much easier actually, to match up the points, or the not the points, the edges. The edges, if you are doing the basting with the thread, which we've done before, but basting with the thread, I don't think we'd have as sharp as edges, so it'd be a little more difficult to match things up and all that. So this is working great so far. I definitely probably consider doing this every time I wanted a paper piece, maybe. Every once in a while, it's fun to fun to thread baste it, but this really is slick. And I think it was the decision to make all the pieces at once that I think is really making this speedy, and I'm really happy we did that. I haven't done that before on paper piecing either, just prep every single piece beforehand so I can just sew it together now. It's just makes it more relaxing, I think. All right, let's tie a little knot here. I'm just going to go up through a little piece of the fabric here on this side. And we're going to kind of do it in that way where we basically tie a French knot. I got to lay it on the ground so it's a little easier. Oh, I know. So mine tonight, Donna, seemed like it was letting go a little bit too. I did, when we started tonight, I had to glue down an edge again. So, oops, my thread came out of the needle. So it was a little annoying, but it's also a good sign because then it's a sign that it'll be easy. I gotta get a clean edge. It'll be easy to pop out the papers later, because if it's, you know, if the glue's too strong, then that could be a problem. So yeah, just grab the glue stick or glue and dab it down a little bit more. I suspect that I'll have to, when we come back to this block sometime, I suspect I'll have to glue down the edges again, which is kind of a bummer. I'm thinking an Elmer's glue or something like that would probably be a bit stronger than my little glue stick, but, you know, I think that that'd almost be too strong. I don't know. I haven't done much with glue yet. All right. There we go. Let's trim that. Oh my gosh, we got so much done. All right, so here is, let's see how it goes with these on the edge. Flatten that out. Oh, I can definitely tell that my finger has done a lot of work, a lot of pinching. So I'll definitely have to stretch that. And yeah, hours, plenty of time for me to be doing this type of handwork. So yeah, so we just have one more blue piece left. That's kind of crazy. So this will go here, and then we just have that one edge to do yet. And then let's get the little blue guys, the little clouds in the corner. Yeah, like right here, it's popping off a little bit. We'll just have to glue it back in place. Luckily now, all these pieces are kind of sewn in, so it won't be that big a deal if some things pop off here and there. But yeah, that's a little annoying. Had to be some setback with glue basting, I suppose. There, it's the sun breaking up the clouds. I like it! And I'm really happy about how much farther. We got two more than I thought we would tonight. Man, we had two. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We were able to do 5 tonight. That's awesome. Yay! All right, I'm going to flip you guys around and we will call it an evening. Hello! So here it is. Coming along. I think this really is quick for paper piecing, for a paper piece block, I think. Like my B block and that other paper piece block, I am definitely not this far. Oop, we go with the bunny on top. There, nope. There we go. That's how it'll look. So thanks again, guys. I will get this up on YouTube. I know I'm still behind. I'm working on that right now, and I'll be working on that. That'll be a big project of my day tomorrow, too, just to getting all the descriptions and getting these up. They're all loaded. They're just not published. I have to write the titles and the descriptions, and that takes a bit of time. So I will get going on that, and this will stay also on Penguin and Fish and on Facebook. So if you, in the Facebook search, go to Penguin and then the ampersand Fish, I should pop up there, and all my videos will be there as well. So thanks again, have a great evening, and I'm excited to see what the block is tomorrow. So we won't be working on this one again until we have another free day. So hopefully it's a quick, easy, slick block that we can do in one session and we have like 4 days left over. So that'd be cool. So all right, have a great evening, guys. Good night.